NFL week number two, time to talk Dallas Cowboys football. And like always, we're talking to Mickey Spagnola, a man who knows a lot about what's going on in Big D. And first thing, that Tampa Bay game, no one gave Dallas a chance to do much of anything. They almost won that game, and it came down to a field goal at the end. Were you surprised by that, or did you expect Dak to go out and do what he did? Because, I mean, you've seen enough practices to kind of make a determination.
Yeah, I wasn't surprised by Dak at all. Now, I didn't think he was going to have to throw the ball 58 times, but I expected him to have no problems with his arm, no problems with his ankle, no problems throwing any pass they wanted him to throw, and he ends up throwing for 403 yards. So, yeah, always thought Dak would be Dak. As for the game, you know what? I thought it was going to be a lot closer than most people anticipated. I know a lot of people had the Cowboys getting blown out like 44-10, and, you know, I thought the game would be closer to like 27-24, 27-21. Didn't know that they could beat Tampa Bay, but I'll tell you what, Van, I can give you five plays. If any one of those five plays had turned out differently, the Cowboys would have beaten the defending Super Bowl champs.
Yeah, and man, for them to take them so deep into that game and really to have a chance to win. I mean, I know a lot of people were talking about the push-off that wasn't called, which led to the field goal, of course, Tampa Bay being in field goal range. Moving on to this week, you got the San Diego Chargers. Los Angeles Chargers now, but anyway, Justin Herbert, is he going to be a handful?
Oh, absolutely. You know, I think that a lot of folks are sitting there going, whoo, we got through Tom Brady. Well, don't exhale just yet, because Justin Herbert, remember, he was last year's NFL Offensive Rookie of the Year. He's awfully good. And the key thing about him, he's a little bit more mobile than Tom Brady. Throws a really nice pass, and he can get outside the pocket. And he doesn't get outside the pocket when there's pressure to necessarily run with the ball, but he can throw on the run outside, so he'll extend plays. And I'll tell you one thing Cowboys defensive coordinator Dan Quinn said about him early in the week. They said it's almost like two plays with him. You got the set play, and then he'll get outside the pocket, and you better be ready to play for another 5 to 7 seconds, because he'll extend the play with his ability, his mobile availability, and still throw on the run. So, yeah, he is a handful. If you look up his history, this guy's an awfully good quarterback.
And I'm sure he'll sleep better knowing that Dan Quinn has some issues himself with DeMarcus Lawrence and the broken foot. What do you do there?
Well, yeah, and they're going to have to figure it out, because they're going to have quite some time. It doesn't look like DeMarcus Lawrence will be back until at the soonest after the bye, so that's a good 5 weeks from now. Fractured fifth metatarsal, so that's your little bone on the outside of your foot. They did do surgery, put a screw in there to facilitate the healing. Next guy up, right? So to me, those next guy up, and it's compounded, Van, right, with Randy Gregory, the other starting defensive end, still on reserve COVID-19, and he's starting to run out of time to come up with those two negative tests if he's asymptomatic. Dorrance Armstrong, really strong training camp. I would imagine he's one of the guys that is the next guy up. And then Terrell Basham, a veteran they signed in free agency. You know, he missed a lot of time in training camp, and he would be the next guy. And then after that, it's a bunch of young guys that really are pretty green. So, yeah, they're going to have their hands full because they've got to get pressure on Justin Herbert.
And you know, just when you get Zach Martin back on that offensive line, you get something like that. And I'm sure the guys are thinking, come on, you know, like, can we get a break sometime?
Yeah, no, exactly. And, you know, so you get Zach Martin back, and then you lose Lyle Collins for five games with the suspension. Looks like Terrence Steele will be the guy that they start at right tackle, but I'm guessing they're going to give him some help. There's going to be a tight end in his hip pocket most of the time to help him out, especially, and I would imagine they do this, the Chargers put Joey Bosa over the right tackle.
And as far as what did you see from week one that makes you positive about everything going forward? Some of the things that you may have seen that that you normally would not see in a preseason game, maybe you saw it in the game and like, oh, I'm encouraged by this.
Well, I'm encouraged. I mean, I got what I expected out of the offense. I thought the offense would be pretty potent this year. Defensively, got to be better. You know, I know they got the four takeaways, but if they don't get those takeaways, that defense wasn't stopping much on a regular basis. So can you count on getting takeaways every time so that means your defense is a little bit better? I don't know. They've got to be better. They've got to be better putting pressure on opposing quarterbacks, and then they lose their two best pressure players in Gregory and Lawrence. So that's going to be a concern going forward. They didn't sack Tom Brady. They got little pressure on him. I think they hit him twice. He threw the ball 50 times. Got to do better than that. So that's got to improve if this defense is going to improve. And if the defense is going to improve, they got to start holding teams to less than 30 points a game. Hard to win when you always got to score 30 or 40 points to win.
You bring up points. What do you think this is going to be? Low scoring, high scoring, in the middle?
I got a feeling it'll be closer to high scoring. I would not be surprised if either team, you know, can't get the 30 points somewhere in there. And if you look around the league, I counted it up. There were 17 teams in week one that scored at least 27 points in the game. So you better get close to 30 if you plan on winning, it seems like, in this NFL.
All right. Thank you so much for your time, Mickey. Really, greatly appreciate it. He's Mickey Spagnola. I'm Van Tate. Chargers and Cowboys on Sunday. We'll see you next time.